What's up, everybody, and welcome to today's video, which will be Jan and Joseph and me talking about Real Steel and Airsoft. Now, real quick about Jan. Jan is one of our new product developers right here. And you guys know Joseph. Yeah, he introduced himself a million times already.
It's still me. Let's start with Real Steel topics.
We have very different opinions on this. We picked the right people with very different opinions. Basically, it's gonna be like the stuff that you learn in Airsoft, does it make sense in Real Steel and also the other way around? So first of all, background check. Joseph.
I've been shooting Real Steel for 5 years, I believe. I took some classes, I train regularly. It's my hobby as well, just like Airsoft.
And Airsoft is 10 years.
Oh, 12.
Yeah, Airsoft to me is 12 years. Real Steel, I don't do much shooting at the range, just maybe like twice a year. For me, it's mostly military trainings, but I think range training and military training is very different.
Well, for me, the most different, I do competitive shooting for a couple years now. Most of them 22s and 9mm.
So is it like target shooting, like the
precision shooting or IPC
speed? No, precision shooting.
Man, that Airsoft must suck for you.
Yeah.
You are always like this.
Yes. Yeah.
What you did? You did it with one hand?
Yeah, one hand.
You are shooting really? One-handed. Yeah. Actually, yeah. I've done it as well, but with the long 22. You have to be super concentrated because you are shooting at this big of a target at 50 meters.
So maybe let's start with the first thing. Precision.
I would say it's not comparable.
No.
Of course.
Airsoft is like
10 meters, maybe.
Yeah, and you immediately get the hop-up effect.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Actually, when I switched to Real Steel, I had a problem. I was shooting too low, and it wasn't a trigger or anything. I was just accounting for the hop-up, subconsciously.
You're not kidding.
I was used to seeing the target and actually aim a little bit lower, so all my groupings were below that. And then I figured I'm actually compensating for hop-up effect.
Well, for me the difference is just when you're shooting Real Steel, you don't see a bullet, you just trust on your sight and take the shot. Yeah. In the end, the paper comes back and say, okay, that's my aim.
And
with Airsoft, you see the BB flying to there, you adjust accordingly. Yeah. Every flat pass could be different depending on situation, wind, everything.
You don't really use your crosses, it's more like
you
take one shot, you remember where the BB went, and not the second
shot
is what's gonna hit.
Exactly. One of my friends runs the AEG, he used the magnifier of the red dot, but he doesn't use the red dot. He just uses it without reticle. And he thinks
makes sense.
You just aim while shooting. It's just
Actually, we made a paintball video, paintball versus airsoft, and there was a guy coming from paintball background, and he was not using any sights on an AEG.
And I think it's fine.
It is. I mean, once you get it in the muscle memory.
Yeah, you just aim to that angle and you jerk it.
Yeah, exactly.
Man, I still remember I was watching the Magpul Dynamics series. So I was watching The Art of Precision Shooting. I was like, man, I have to watch this. It was before the military. And I was like, man, I'm gonna learn so much from this video on how I can be a better Airsoft sniper. And I was like, man, I'm gonna do all of this stuff in Airsoft. And then I shot the first shot. And it was like, all of this is completely useless.
Because you watched the wrong video, you should watch Dynamic rifle. When it comes to precision shooting, there is like airsoft is completely different thing. There is actually no such thing as precision shooting in airsoft.
Yeah. Okay, that was precision. What about gun handling? What do you do in airsoft? You know, in airsoft people go like, oh, there's somebody. And you kind of like, you kind of bring the gun where it needs to be, and then you're like, okay, I'm not allowed to blind fire. So you just kind of like bring your eye into the sight and then you take the shot.
It's like the First World War trench warfare with a sniper above, you use a periscope and point.
Yeah, exactly.
You can do it in Real Steel as well. It's not a problem. You can shoot a rifle. You can shoot a rifle like this. If you hold it securely.
The first shot
You can. It's not gonna be super accurate, but you can do it.
If you point it at the right thing and you pull the trigger, it doesn't matter if it's supported or not. You can
if you are shooting...
would have left the barrel before the recoil action starts.
If you are shooting over a car, you obviously don't wanna do this when the car is here. So you do actually something like this something along these lines.
Don't do that in airsoft.
Airsoft, you're gonna shoot sideways. You're gonna shoot the guy in the corner.
Yeah. But the point is, you don't need to really shoulder the gun properly.
Yeah.
Even in a real steel.
Well, at the military, we learned like almost like body center.
That's the best way.
Yes, and then you kind of like bring yourself into the sight. Well, you say it's the best way. How do you shoot an airsoft? Do you shoot it like the real one?
I did a video in which I was comparing like real steel and airsoft.
But you were using a gas blowback rifle.
Gas blowback rifle, yes. I was switching to real steel and airsoft, and I was just holding the gun the same.
So now pistols. Something that you criticized on the last video was that I'm shooting like this.
Yes.
That's typical airsoft thing. That is for airsoft.
If you are purely doing airsoft, technically I don't have a problem with that when I see it.
But that's a lot of these people. If you get that hobby and you go to real steel suddenly and nobody tell you how to do it, you're gonna lose a tooth, you're gonna break your nose.
Yeah, or you lose your eye.
Yeah, even worse. I have seen people putting a scope so close, take a shot and bang, black eye.
Okay, but I mean, real airsoft, what are we doing? We are replicating a warfare, let's put it this way. In my opinion, everybody should strive to handle the gun properly. Trigger off the finger, finger off the trigger, and like the grip, you know, that's what I do.
If it's not a Milsim dedicated game, you will have disadvantage by following some rules that are for your safety, but for real steel.
If you enter a room, for example, like do you go into the room and you do that?
It's called cutting a pie. When I'm cutting a pie, I actually do this and I move up, down and checking everything.
Yeah, but then again,
and then
you have hot
other pot. Side. It's a room. It's a room. Yeah. I can hit a guy when I'm in a room. That's what I learned in the classes. And that's what I do in airsoft as well. How do you do it? I mean, the airsoft variant.
Sometimes I don't even look down the sides. It's like, okay, there's a wall right here. And it's kind of like, I go like this. So I see what I'm shooting, but it's also not my eye that's here. It's kind of like, you know, just so I can see around the corner. So I'm as little exposed as possible. Mm. And then it's also, maybe the first shot even misses, but I see the beam and it's like, and then heavy.
Well, then again, that was it. You were aiming using a BB, not a sight.
Yes. So
anyways, let's address the elephant in the room. Obviously, there is no BBs. We check the guns. We are pulling triggers to illustrate something, but the guns are completely safe. There is no BBs whatsoever.
One other thing, an advantage that I see with doing that is when you have an optic on your pistol. Mm. Because when you hold it all the way out, you actually have to find the right angle because the window gets so small. It's like, oh, where's the dot? I know if you train it over and over and over, yes,
you get it.
You can learn it, but even if it's in your muscle memory, I think if you're in a really, you know, in an airsoft situation, a guy just comes around the corner and it's like, maybe you don't find the dot. Like, I literally run around like this.
You can always see the dot.
Yes. And the only distance I keep between the red dot or the pistol and my face is like the movement of the hammer, and it almost hits my mesh mask. Yeah. That's how close it is.
This thing actually can make you pretty quiet in yourself. In real steel, there's no point doing this because in one shot, everybody hears you. No matter what.
Yeah. I give you that. I mean, that's a good point. That's an advantage.
I think that's also a funny aspect that people try to get their guns so quiet. People take those pistols and they shoot it and they go like, how could I make it more quiet? And they start like messing around with the suppressor and all of this to make it like 1 decibel more quiet. But actually airsoft guns, like even a normal AEG, if it's in a forest and you're like 20 meters away, you barely hear it. It's like,
And the gas blowback for airsoft players are super scared if you start blasting with a gas blowback rifle.
Actually, people start sometimes
you can dry fire. You can dry fire and people still start surrender. Just in the line of fire, start blasting. I was like, geez, it wasn't.
Happened to me multiple times. Next topic.
What else do we have?
The role of the sniper.
Yes. Airsoft. Yes. Okay. The role of the sniper in airsoft. That's also something, man. When I went to the military for the sniper training, I was like, man, when I come out of this training, I'm gonna go to the field and I'm gonna kill it. After those several months of training, I went to the field, like nothing worked.
Nothing. It was completely
useless. You know, what you learn at the military is cover yourself completely, especially the back, because you're always gonna be lying.
I tried it twice, it hurt my elbow.
Airsoft sniper couldn't be far from the real sniper.
Yes.
Like in the military, you always like crawl, you do like 5 tempos and then you listen for half an hour.
Yes.
And then you do 5 more tempos.
And that's what I did. You know, it was like, game start! And I ran to the, I ran to the first tree and was like, okay, stealth mode on. The actual battle is happening 200 meters in front of you, and you kind of go like, okay, I'm gonna sneak up like really slow, and you're like, you know, you move slowly and you crawl, and when you're there, the game is over. It's
scary, active sniping, that's what we all do, right? Yeah. We are just running to the front line.
Exactly what I do. Yeah. The game start, I try to run as far as possible, take a position and snipe out there first, the other side, and I know I'm probably gonna die if I don't. Other AEGs don't give me backup.
So that's probably the biggest difference in airsoft versus real steel. Like with a sniper, you just do completely different thing in airsoft. Yes.
I was questioning a lot if a scope on a sniper rifle actually makes sense. And I tried a Red Dot once, and then I learned that you don't have the scope on there for aiming. You have it for BB tracking.
Exactly. Yes. Exactly.
You wouldn't even need a crosshair.
I mean,
target spotting. And you use it to track your shot.
I mean, I'm gonna disagree. I still aim with the scope.
Yeah. We all do. It's a reference. It's a reference. On a distance, I'm self-conscious enough to know I'm not expecting it to hit the middle of the crosshair.
When it comes to scopes, I hate changing the magnification.
Yeah, I don't
because it completely messes up your memory, how the BB should actually fly, and if you zoom in, you cannot judge the distance and it's gonna fly over or under the target. So
I was using a 4x40 for a really, really long time, and I always had that opinion, but once I changed to the variable one, I think there's a point sometimes, because if it's a foggy day and you just cannot see the BB, man, if you cannot see the BB, you cannot snipe.
I remember one situation very well. You were playing at Katkowice with me. It was foggy day.
Yeah.
And you were in like a building and you were shooting into the door of other building, and I just couldn't see there in the shadows in the door. And I remember from your video that you just cranked up the scope, and then you gave like two headshots. I'm like,
in the dark, it's super useful. Wow.
So that's sniping, completely different. You cannot just, you know, stay back a kilometer and just...
But we shouldn't forget about ghillie guys.
But if you do that, I think you're better off not using a sniper. I think you're better off just using this thing. If you have a ghillie, you want to play the field where there's lots of vegetation. But now you only have one BB and it hits a branch. But it's like, fuck, I missed. Okay, he doesn't know where I am. So it's like, okay, now I got through the branches. Now you hit him. That's also different. Cover. Cover is a huge
cover difference. Versus concealment.
Yes. Any airsoft cover would not defend yourself against the bullet. Or most of them. Actually, a bush in front of you is cover enough. It's like, oh, a guy shoots at me and you hear that. Okay, now I'm gonna run away. Yeah. It's not gonna
hit me. Yeah, actually, I hate that because there's some people, you don't really know if you hit them or not, but you gave them like, you unload the entire meat cap into that bush. You know that guy is there. You think he's probably cheating, and the guy probably is some of it, but what? How do you consider it a ricochet or do you consider it a duel?
Yeah, it's always hard. It's always hard for the shooter and actually for the people you are shooting at as well. Also, what happens to me sometimes when I'm really hiding in a bush, I know they cannot shoot at me because there's like a wall or something, but there is BBs actually falling on top of my head because the bush stops it and you just like ding ding and you call it or like. That's an interesting thing.
Okay, what about rifles?
When I see a real steel gun that doesn't have backup sights, I'm like, man, you cannot afford to lose your aiming option in real steel, obviously.
Depends on the situation.
I always put flip-up sights on all of my guns. Correction, I actually take them off because I have the camera, but... I mean, I would love to have them.
I would immediately take them off. It's just unnecessary weight.
Back when I had them, I was just... Just so everybody don't tell me that I don't have backup sights. That's about it, because I don't see the use of it.
You are right, I give you that. I mean, I'm forced to take them off because of the cameras, but...
You never use them.
Yeah. Also, safety. I don't know how you learn it, like, at the range, how it is in Czech Republic, but at the military, your gun is always unsafe, even if there's, like, enemy contact. And it's like, now there's an enemy.
Yes.
You bring the gun up, while you bring it up, you put it on fire, you take the shot, while you put it down, you bring it, you put it back on safe. Man, if you do that in airsoft, your safety probably breaks off after like 2 game days or something.
That's a training issue. I mean, if military people, if special forces can do it with safety on, I'm sure we can do it with safety on. So
that's what I was saying. Military guy can go to airsoft, but airsoft can't go reverse.
No. For most people in airsoft, the safety, from what I've seen, more or less doesn't exist. It's always
safety.
On fire. This is your That's such a bullshit. That cannot be more wrong. And I heard it so many times. And I never argue with those people because it's just... Anyways, safety, please. It's there for a reason. I mean, if you don't want to have the gun on safe when you are playing, okay, fine. But when you are on the respawn, be mindful of just...
Yeah, for competitive use shooting, it's even worse. Something I want to add is, well, AEGs, you can... It's really easy to set up AEG to work. You can buy the cheapest red dot, nothing real steel, and it will work. You can't do the same to a gas gun. And you certainly can't do it on real steel. You shoot, the recoil is like, red dot on, off. Each shot just disconnects the battery or something.
Yeah, and actually that was my biggest problem when I was testing this gun. I was so afraid that this won't work. I shot like a million BBs out of the thing just to make sure the red dot can take
actually,
it.
These red dots, for some reason, the battery is actually very well clamped. It's the bigger ones that have the issue.
Yes, and this red dot can take it. So guys, one more topic that is huge in airsoft, from what I've seen. Blind fire. What's your opinion on blind fire? In real steel, I can take a pistol and I can shoot like this behind the cover. I can do whatever and I'm able to hold the gun and I can blind fire. So why do people ban
against it? I am against when it's a guy, let's say with a Polar Star, for the holding just like this. I'm against that kind of. In real steel, if I'm doing that on full auto, it doesn't work. I'm going to be shooting at the sky.
I think it's more like because airsoft is a gentleman's sport. It's like about fairness and giving the other player the chance to win. And it's not about winning, right? It's about all the people having fun. And
yeah,
what can happen? Like
that's the thing. It's about having fun.
Yes. Let's say there's a corner and I just go like...
Not even that. Instead of clear a room that require, for example, a teammate help, you just take your gun. That's it.
If it's full auto and you have like 30 rounds per second, it's not the nicest thing.
It's like kind of I'm having a bag of BB, I just toss into it.
Man, I tell you, if blind fire would be allowed in airsoft, the airsoft field would look so different. I think people would be like, you're a really good airsoft player if you really know how to blind fire. And you're gonna learn like, okay, I see a target, how can I shoot the target like this? And you just look like through a hole in a wooden board or something. Usually the game rules are you have to give the enemy the chance to hit you, and the hole you're shooting through must be so big that you can fit your head to it. And I think that's great. I think it's a great rule.
And that's a big difference to real steel. I mean, if you are looking through a hole in a piece of wood, it's not really a cover, it's concealment in real steel, so you can shoot through. My point of view is, if somebody blind fires, I don't mind, because I take it as, okay, it's possible in real steel, but there is one thing, and I actually kind of realized that recently, blind fire, it's for the safety of trespassers or civilians. Because if you are blind firing, you don't know what you are shooting at in most cases. So I think that's the only thing that, at least to me, makes sense. You don't want to injure anyone who's not like part of the game. And for that, you have to be able to identify the target. This also correlates to real steel firearms safety rules. You have to identify the target and know what's beyond the target.
Okay, that's been it. We just cracked the 40-minute mark. Our editor, Matthias, will cut it down to 15 minutes, hopefully somehow. So thanks for that, Matthias. Hope you guys enjoyed. For you guys, thanks for joining. And let us know another topic. Like, do you guys enjoy this kind of videos? What should we talk about? Let us know in the comments below. And we see you on the next one.